A stranger in our halls. Welcome. Our name is Samuel, and we will do our best to assist you. Please tell us what brings you here.
I told him that I was looking for my Uncle Fred.
We should help. Do you know where he is?
Fred left us without a word. If you aspire to find him, we can share with you a sacred crystal, a power core. Fred used their kind to power his suit. You can have it if you return our Fred to us.
The crystal? Sweet!
Madeline, that was inappropriate. Your help will not be necessary. The crystal is not for you to have.
What? I want to help finding Fred. Why couldn't I?
Please, Madeline, that is impossible. None of us may enter the chasms. It is too dangerous.
What's the danger? If Fred can do it, so can I.
I say this for your own protection, Madeline. You are forbidden from entering the chasms.
Just because you're afraid of what's outside the village doesn't mean I am. I'm nothing like you. I'll never be.
We apologize. It is true that we want to keep her safe, but she does not understand. Behind us is the power core. Take it and go into the chasms. Find Fred, and if you see Madeline, take care of her. Be safe.
I felt a little uneasy about moving on into the chasms. If it was too dangerous for Maddie, would it be safe enough for me?
Thank you. Yes.
Darkness swept over me as I left the glittering lights in the village behind me and headed for the ominous shadows of the chasms. As I entered the chasms, it struck me how much darker it was in there. The shadows were black as ink, and although I tried not to be afraid, I couldn't help but shiver. Was it the darkness that frightened the villagers as well? Or was it something else? Thank you. Maddie?
Hi, I'm glad you came. Sorry about back there. I just get so frustrated. They cling so desperately to what they know, won't ever do anything new. It feels better when Fred is around, but...
I told Madeline I didn't mind, and I asked her what she was doing with the book.
Oh, this? These writings? It's like a secret language. They are done by people who left the village long ago. They're called the Strays. But no one wants to talk about them. I started translating their language with help from a stray book that Fred found. This one says, "Don't move when the eye is open," I think. I wonder what it means. Whatever. We should get going. Why don't you take me on your back? It'll be faster if you carry me. I used to piggyback on Fred all the time. Turn around and I'll hop up. You're not going to drop me, right? Okay, let's go.
Madeline climbed up on my back, and with the suit on, I could barely feel the extra weight. Winding, narrow tunnels felt like they were closing in on me. They were oddly long and twisting, almost like someone or something had dug them out. With Maddie on my back, I had to be careful not to bump her head on the ceiling.
Ordinary people living in the village long ago. They disagreed with the old traditions and left to form their own village, or they were thrown out for misbehaving. The stories differ a bit.